Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 5th of October. Two paramilitary personnel killed, three injured in terrorist attack in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Baloch activists in Canada highlight Pakistani atrocities in Balochistan. And Sri Lankan Prime Minister alleges opposition spreading lies about 20th Amendment to Constitution. And now for all the details. Two soldiers of India's paramilitary Central Reserve Police Force were killed and three others injured after terrorists opened fire at a patrolling party near Kandi Jal Bridge in Pampor town of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory on Monday. The injured personnel were evacuated to the district hospital where two succumbed to their injuries, the CRPF said in a statement. Firing by the terrorists occurred at around 12:50 p.m. local time, when CRPF troops along with Jammu and Kashmir police personnel were carrying out road opening operations. A search operation was underway till the last reports came in and the area had been cordoned off. This is the fourth attack on the security forces in the same area in the last few weeks. Amid border tensions with China and Pakistan, Indian Air Force Chief Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria on Monday said that Indian Air Force is ready for any possible conflict, including a two-front war.
Indian Air Force Chief Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria on Monday said that the Indian Air Force was ready for any possible conflict, including a two-front war. Bhadauria's comments come at a time when bilateral ties between India and China have been tense since May due to the border standoff along the line of actual control. When asked whether they are ready to deal with any challenge from China in India's northern Ladakh territory, he said the force is very well positioned during a press briefing ahead of the National Air Force Day on October 8.
किसी भी कन्वेंशनल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट के लिए और किसी भी तरह के कॉन्फ्लिक्ट के लिए फुल्ली प्रिपेयर्ड है एंड उसमें टू फ्रंट वॉर भी इंक्लूडेड है हमारी हमेशा ये फोकस रहता है कि हमारी ऑपरेशनल कैपेबिलिटी करंट थ्रेट सिनेरियो के अगेंस्ट बिल्डअप की जाए अगेंस्ट प्रिपेयर्ड रहे एंड हमारी कैपेबिलिटी पूरी तरह से तैयार है.
India has been locked in a bitter standoff with China along the line of actual control since April-May over the transgressions by the Chinese army in multiple areas in eastern Ladakh. Military heads of both countries have engaged in several rounds of talks over the last 3 months, but these talks have so far failed to break the impasse.
Galvanized by the alleged gang rape and subsequent death of a 19-year-old woman in India's Hathras town, opposition political parties continued to hold protests across the country on Monday, decrying inaction.
Members of the Congress and other opposition political parties continued to hold protests across India on Monday, as anger over the alleged gang rape and subsequent death of a 19-year-old woman in Hathras town of northern Uttar Pradesh state continued to grow. The victim's family, belonging to the lowest rung of the caste system in India, has accused four high-caste Hindu men who have been arrested but not charged by police, which has claimed there were no traces of rape in the woman's post-mortem report. Outrage and protests have sparked in the country as the victim's family has demanded a judicial probe to be conducted, even as the case has been handed over to the Central Bureau of Investigation by the ruling Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP-led government in Uttar Pradesh.
The whole country, the conscience of this country is shaken today because a girl was brutally raped and killed and the BJP is supporting the rapist.
Public criticism mounted in recent days after the victim's family said her body was cremated by police without their consent, an allegation officials deny. A latest forensic report of the woman's samples sent 11 days after the incident said there were no signs suggestive of intercourse, backing the state police's version that the victim was not raped or gang-raped.
Moving on, Baloch activists in Canada carried out a protest this past weekend against gross human rights violations by Pakistan in Balochistan. The protesters demanded immediate release of missing Baloch persons languishing in detention centers for opposing China-Pakistan economy corridor, which they say has only brought death and destruction in the region.
Baloch right activists in Canada this past weekend protested against atrocities by Pakistan and Balochistan and demanded immediate release of activists and innocent civilians languishing in detention centers of Pakistani security forces. They demanded end of military occupation of Balochistan while commemorating the fourth year of disappearance of student leader Shabir Ahmad Baloch and 29 others who were allegedly abducted by Pakistani army on October 4, 2016 for agitating against the construction of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC in the region.
Baloch lands are being sold. Thousands of Baloch people have been disappeared in the protest, and Shabir Ahmad is the leader of that protest. And we demand here immediate release of Shabir Ahmad and all the disappeared persons in Balochistan.
Activists have long blamed CPEC, which reaches out from China's Xinjiang region to Balochistan's Gwatar port, has only brought death and destruction for the local people instead of economic opportunities, and accused Pakistani security forces have been given a free hand to eliminate voices against the illegal project.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani is leading a high government delegation headed to Kuwait and Qatar, the presidential palace informed on Monday. Ghani's trip to Qatar comes at a time when direct talks between negotiating teams of Afghan government and the Taliban are yet to begin, 22 days after the opening ceremony in Doha.
Afghanistan's President Ashraf Ghani is travelling to Qatar for a bilateral meeting with Qatari leaders, a presidential palace statement informed on Monday. Ghani, along with the delegation, was scheduled to stop first in Kuwait to attend the funeral ceremony of Kuwait's late emir before travelling to Qatar. The statement, however, did not mention whether Ghani will be holding any meetings with Taliban officials or not, although peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban are underway in Qatari capital Doha. The intra-Afghan negotiations that started last month are aimed at warring sides agreeing to a reduction of violence and possible new power-sharing agreement in Afghanistan. According to local media reports, in the latest, the Taliban has demanded recognition of the US Taliban agreement signed in February as the mother deal underlying the Afghan peace negotiations and Hanafi jurisprudence as the sole religious legal guidelines for the talks. Reports say that the Afghan government's team has suggested alternatives to the Taliban's demands.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Ever since the Sri Lankan government proposed 20th constitution amendment last month, it has faced resistance from the opposition as well as within the ruling party parliamentary group members. Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa has now hit out at the opposition for spreading lies about 20th amendment reducing powers of Auditor General.
Sri Lankan Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa has hit out at the opposition for spreading false propaganda that the Presidential Secretariat and the Prime Minister's Secretariat will be removed from the purview of the Auditor General by the 20th Amendment to the Constitution. In a statement released on Sunday, Rajapaksa pointed out that since the inception of the 1978 Constitution, both of these have always been within the purview of the Auditor General. According to Mahinda Rajapaksa, the main misconception is that the 19th Amendment created an audit commission. The 20th Amendment is going to abolish it. He explained that the 19th Amendment did not create an audit commission, but only the establishment of an audit services commission.
This audit commission does not carry out any audit activities. Ever since the Sri Lankan government proposed 20th constitution amendment last month, it has faced resistance from the opposition. The 20th amendment proposes to restore full legal immunity to the president, removing the provisions made in the 19A to take legal action against the president. Moving on to news from Nepal. Markets in Nepal's capital Kathmandu have started witnessing crowds ahead of country's biggest religious celebration, Dashain, amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Despite rising cases, shoppers who are all in festive mood can be seen flouting social distancing and other basic health protocols.
Locals in Nepali capital Kathmandu have started thronging nearby markets to do their festive shopping, with the country's biggest religious celebration, Dashain, approaching amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Kathmandu, being the worst hit state, has been contributing over 50-70% of daily coronavirus infections reported around Nepal. Despite the increasing infection cases, buzz in markets can be witnessed where social distancing, sanitization and other basic health protocols are being flouted by shoppers who are all in festive mood to celebrate the Dashain late this month.
अब लकडाउनले त धेरै असर परेको नै छ हैन अब त्यसको अलावा चाहिँ हामीले आफै सुरक्षित भएर अब भनम न दूरी कायम गरेर भिडभाडमा धेरै नगएर मास्कहरू लगाएर अनि आफू चाहिँ सुरक्षित रहेर त्यो गरे भने चाहिँ हुन्छ त्यसमा चाहिँ कन्ट्रोल ल्याउन सकिन्छ
मान्छे आफैमा सचेत हुनु पर्छ जस्तो लाग्छ जस्तो सोसल डिस्टेन्सिङको कुरा छ सैनिटाइजेसनको कुरा छ हैन अब हामीले एकदम भिड यहाँ देखिरहेका छौँ मान्छेहरू कोही त अब मास्क नलाइकन पनि हिँडिरहनु भएको छ गभर्मेन्टको स्टेप एकातिर छ भने मान्छे आफैमा पनि सचेत हुँदा चाहिँ यो अलिकति कन्ट्रोल हुन्थ्यो कि जस्तो मलाई लाग्छ
नेपाल रिसेन्टली एन्डेड 7 months लङ रिस्ट्रिक्सन्स इम्पोज टु कन्टेन दि भाइरस स्प्रेड विच वाज डोमिनेन्ट इन सदर्न प्लेन्स अफ दि कन्ट्री now eventually turning to capital Kathmandu. In the latest, 4 advisors of Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli, along with a dozen guards stationed at the Premier's residence, tested positive for the virus, creating panic and surprise amongst people.
At a time when almost every business is affected around the world due to COVID-19 pandemic, government in India's Jammu and Kashmir has organized a cocoon auction for the benefit of local growers in Srinagar city. Cocoons of Jammu and Kashmir are considered one of the best quality around the world, which people generally buy for their silk businesses.
The government in India's Jammu and Kashmir has set up a cocoon auction market in the Union Territory's summer capital Srinagar for the benefit of farmers amid the COVID-19 pandemic. September and October are the only 2 months when the growers prepare their cocoons for sale. The cocoon auction market is set up so that the farmers can sell the cocoons at competitive rates to buyers from within Jammu and Kashmir and from outside the territory.
बाहर से आते हैं, बम्बई से आते हैं, बेंगलोर से भी आते हैं। इसमें खुशुसियत है, खासकर कश्मीरी जो ये है, कश्मीर का अभ्रेशम जो है, इसकी बहुत खुशुसियत है।
कुप्ते है ना, वो हम लोग लेने आया। वो लेने आया इस साल कोरोना का वजह से हालत भी बहुत ख़राब है इसलिए इधर आज से मार्केट शुरू हुआ है हम तो बहुत साल पहले से आता है 20 साल से आता है लेकिन इस साल हालत बहुत ख़राब है इसलिए रेशम भी बाहर तो नहीं जाता है पूरा इंटरनेशनल मार्केट सब बंद है
The cocoon auction market is an annual event which authorities in Jammu and Kashmir organize to facilitate the local farmers. However, this year it holds more importance than ever as the pandemic has hit hard almost every business around the globe. Over 78,000 positive cases of COVID-19 have been reported and the associated death toll has crossed the 1,000 mark in Jammu and Kashmir alone in India.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.